Hello everyone, welcome to all in this lecture. So far we have discussed 22 questions from the GATE previous year question from this bearing capacity of shell topic. In this lecture also I'm going to discuss some more GATE previous year questions. So let's start. So the first question we have for the C5 shell, question C is given 50 kilopascal. Total unit weight is given 20 kilonewton per meter cube, and bearing capacity factor is given NC and NQ and gamma. Using Terjaghi formula, calculate net ultimate bearing capacity. It means we have to calculate Q and U. For a strip footing, width is 2 meter and a depth is 1 meter. Depth of foundation is given 1 meter. Considering shear failure only, so Terjaghi has given the bearing capacity factor by considering shear failure only. So no need to think here. You will calculate the QU directly using the bearing capacity, Terjaghi bearing capacity theory. Okay, next, estimate the safe load on a footing 10 meter long by 2 meter wide strip footing using a factor of safety, 3. So we have to calculate safe load. In the question, it is not mentioned total safe load. So safe load, it means we have to calculate Q and H into area. And it is asking for how much area? So this is the area, that is 10 into 2. So for calculation Q and H, we need, what is the Q and H? Q and U divided by factor of safety. Factor of safety is given. So we need here to calculate Q and U, that is QU minus overburden pressure, gamma DF. And this we can calculate using the Terjaghi theory. Right? So from here to, we have to reach here to there. Right. Okay. So let's calculate the ultimate bearing capacity of a shell. So first, write the general expression for the strip footing, that is NC, CNC plus gamma DF NQ plus 0.5, because this is the strip footing, BN gamma. So this is the C5 shell. Okay, and water table is not mentioned. It means water table is much greater depth compared to the width of footing. So whatever the given the well density, we will use everywhere. So let's calculate. C is given 50, NC is given 8, gamma is given 20, depth of foundation is 1, NQ, that is 3 plus 0.5 gamma into 20 into B, width is 2 meter. You cannot take this. This is asking for safe load. Here, ultimate bearing capacity for width footing is given 2 meter. So B into N gamma. N gamma is 2. So you can calculate. I'm writing this directly because I have calculated already. So while watching this lecture, first you calculate, then you see you are getting this answer or not. So I've calculated and I get this 500 kilonewton per meter square. So I'm writing over here. So now we can calculate net ultimate. So that is QU minus overburden pressure, gamma DF. So 500 minus gamma 20, depth of foundation is 1, so we got 480. So now we can calculate QNH. And first question asking about this. So we have calculated this. Right? Okay, factor of safety. So 480 divided by factor of safety, that is 3. So we got 160 kilonewton per meter square. Then we can calculate safe load. Safe load for 10 meter long strip footing by 2 meter wide. So that is QNH into area, means 160 into 10 into 2. You will get 3200 kiloNewton. Are you getting my point? So this type of question already have discussed in the previous lecture also. So let's go for the next questions. Next question we have. Using the Terzaghi theory, determine ultimate bearing capacity of a stiff footing. Footing 1.5 meter wide resting on the saturated clay. Resting on the saturated clay. So resting, it means depth of foundation is zero. Okay, so it is given Cu is equal to 5U, Cu is equal to 30 kiloNewton per meter square and 5U is equal to Gu, comma saturated at a depth of 2 meter below the ground level. No, in this case, depth of foundation is not a zero. Wide resting on the saturated clay, that is 2 meter below the ground level. So here depth of foundation will be 2 meter, okay? The water table also at the depth of 2 meter below the ground level. It means water table is at the base of foundation. At the base of foundation. If the water table rises by 1 meter, calculate the percentage reduction in the ultimate bearing capacity. So you will see when the water level rises, so we will get some reduction in the ultimate bearing capacity. So this is basically two cases. Case one, when suppose this is the ground surface. And depth of foundation is given 2 meter. So in the first case, water level is at the, this is the water level, water table, you can say a water level, you can also say. So this is at the base of the footing. But in the second case, suppose this is the case second. So in the second case, suppose this is the ground surface. Ground surface. So water level is rise up to 1 meter. So it is riser up to 1 meter. This is the depth of foundation, 2 meter. So what we have to do, we will calculate ultimate bearing capacity for the first case, and also we will calculate ultimate bearing capacity for second case. And then we can find reduction. So percentage reduction will be QU 1 minus QU 2 divided by QU 1 to 100. So we'll get some reduction. So we'll take the percentage. So we have to calculate this one. So for calculating this percentage reduction, we have to calculate ultimate bearing capacity from the both the cases, right? So let's calculate what will be in the first case. So just first write the general expression CNC gamma TF and Q plus 0.5 because this is the strip footing. Okay. So now we can phi is equal to given zero, it means NC is equal to 5.7 in Q1 or N gamma is zero. So by putting the N gamma is equal to zero, this expression will be zero. Right? So let's calculate. C is given 30 into NC 5.7 plus gamma. Or gamma is given 20 into depth of foundation given 2 and Q is 1. So you will calculate and you will get the value I have calculated. So I'm writing directly. So I'm writing over here and that is 211. right? Now we can calculate for the second case also. So first write the general expression CNC gamma DF NQ, and here we also we can write WQ. Why I am writing, I will explain. 0.5 gamma B and gamma. See, in this case, for the third expression, in this case, this weight of the soil which is beneath the footing, so in this case, it will be submerged. This is the overburden pressure, so this will be in the bulk condition. See here, when the water table is rising up to here, so this will become a submerged, and there we have to add some water reduction factor. Here is also water reduction factor, that is W gamma, but that value will be equal to 1, if you will see. Right? Okay. So let's first calculate what will be the reduction factor, water reduction factor. Okay. So WQ will basically 1 minus 0.5 into A divided by DF, and it should be not greater than 1, less than equal to 1. Okay, what is the A? So A is the distance of water table from the base of the footing, and that is we have calculated, that is we have here, that is 1 meter, and depth of foundation 2 meter. So we can calculate 1 minus 0.5 into 1 divided by 2. You will get 0.75, and that is less than or equal to 1. Right. Rest we know. Okay. So now we can calculate C 30 into 5.7 plus gamma, that is 20, into depth of foundation, that is 2, into NQ 1, reduction factor, that is 0.75. So you will get this value 201 kilonewton per meter square. I have calculated, so I'm writing over here. So now we can calculate percentage reduction in ultimate bearing capacity of soil. You can write ultimate bearing capacity of soil. So that will be QU1 minus QU2 divided by QU1 to 100. So that we have 201 divided by 200. And you will get, I've calculated, so I'm writing over here, 4.74%. Right. So you can see there is a reduction when the water table rises. When the water table rises, you can get reduction by 10. So let's go for the next question. Question number 25 that we have. A strip footing is to be designed to carry a gross load 900 kilonewton. What is this gross load? So we can write this gross load is equal to QH into area. At a depth of 1 meter in a gravelly sand, so C is equal to 0. Depth of foundation is given 1 meter. The appropriate shear strength parameters C phi and phi, C dash is equal to 0, phi dash 38 degree, determine the width of the footing. So we have to calculate width. If factor of safety is given 3, again shear failure, water table is found to be at foundation level. Water table is found to be foundation level. Above the water table, the saturated unit weight is 18. And below the water table, saturated unit weight is 20 kilonewton per meter cube. It means, see, whatever the soil which is above the water table, that is also saturated. And below the water table, that's all, obviously, that will in the submerged conditions. So you can see that is given 18. So above the water, soil which is above the water table, that is also in the saturated condition, but that have a different density. So for 538 degree, ultimate bearing capacity factor is given, and Q and gamma and unit weight of water is also given. So see, we have to calculate B. So what will happen? This, see, this data is given. 900 divided by QS into area. So area, when we will write for the strip footing, so what we can write? B into 1, right? So B is a known. QS we can calculate by QNS plus gamma DF. QNS we can calculate QNU divided by factor of safety. QNU we calculate QU minus gamma DF. So this we can calculate by using the Terzaghi theory. So we have to reach from here to here. So only B is unknown, this is all expression. So B we can find, that we have to do. So let's calculate ultimate bearing capacity of a strip footing in terms of B. So first write the general expression, CNC plus gamma DF and Q 0.5, because this is a strip footing, gamma B and gamma. And let's make a figure. Suppose this is the ground surface. This is the ground surface, and depth of water, depth of foundation is given 1 meter, and this is the sand. Unit weight is given above the water table. Water table is here at the base of the footing. This will come up here. Right? Water table is here. And this saturated is given, density is given 20, and this saturated is given 80. So do not confuse with this. Okay. So you can see when the water table at the base of the footing, this will be in the submerged condition. This will be in the bulk condition, but here also bulk condition in the soil is in saturated, right? So here also will be saturated. So by putting the value of C is equal to zero, this expression will be zero. So now we can write 18 into comma DF, so that is 1 into NQ. So what is NQ? Is given 49 plus 0.5 into gamma, that is in the submerged condition. So that will be gamma saturated minus W, unit weight of water, gamma W. So this is what saturation? We are working here. So saturation will be 20. So 20 minus 9.81. into B into N gamma, that is 67. So by calculating, you will get, I have already calculated, so I'm writing over here, 882 plus 34, 1.365 into B. So we get ultimate bearing capacity in terms of B. Now we can calculate net ultimate. So that is QU minus gamma DF. So we get 864 plus 341.365 B. What we can calculate next? QNS. That is QNU divided by factor of safety. So we'll get factor of safety is given. This question, factor of safety was given, I think. Yeah, 3. Factor of safety is 3. So you will get this value, QNS 288 plus 113.78 B. So now we can calculate, QNS is this. So now we can calculate QS. So what is QS? QNS plus gamma DF. So we can get 306 plus 113.78 B. And now we can equate gross load, carry a gross load, that is 900 kilonewton per meter into, we can multiply this area per meter. So this into B, now load is given per, load is given, so we can calculate gross load, that is 900 kilonewton per meter. We have to calculate this one also, kilonewton per meter. So what we can do, we can write Q is into area, Q is into B into 1, because this is the strip footing and we are working per unit run. We are calculating per unit run. So we can write 900 equal to 306 plus 113.78 B. So you will get quadratic equation, and by solving that you will get B is equal to 1.772 meter, right? In this expression you will say only B is unknown. Only B is unknown, thus you will get B is equal to 1.772. So you can see there why I'm writing B into 1, because this is the strip footing. So this is the width. This is the width and length will be 1 meter. So B into 1 I'm writing. Okay. So by calculating this, by solving this quadratic equation, we can get the V value, capital V, that is width of footing. With a strip footing. So let's go for the next question. Always, when you are reading the question, first note down what are the data given. Sometimes you can see data are given in the directly, but sometimes some data are given in the words format. They are saying something, you have to understand what is meaning of that, right? And then just note down what you have to calculate, and always try to reach what is given and what we have to find. And always try to get some relation. Always try to remember some relation. So by using the some relation, you have to reach, you can reach from given to the what we have to calculate, right? So next question, we have a 2 meter wide strip footing is placed 1 meter below the ground surface. So you can see this is the given depth of foundation. And this is the given 2 meter. Okay, below the ground surface of a clay soil, having a flowing properties, Cu, an undrained cohesion is given 80, and effective cohesion is given 0. Undrained phi is given, internal angle of friction for undrained condition is given 0, effective condition is given 30 degree. Unit weight above the water table is 16, gamma saturated is given 20. For the first condition, if water table is at the foundation level, calculate the net safe bearing capacity. We have to calculate QNS of the footing using the factor of safety 2 for short term and long term condition. Second, also indicate the change that may occur in the short term value when the water table rises to the ground level. Okay, so all this property we have, you have to be very focused at this level, at this point, where the years in the question is mentioned, we have to calculate QNH, one for the short term and second for the long term. What is the meaning of this? You will say when you're working on the short term, whatever the cohesion and phi will be in the effective condition, will be in the will be in the undrained condition. And for the long term, it will be in the undrained condition. So drainage had not occurred. It means drainage had not occurred. Okay, and for the long term, we kept that soil and the footing for the long term. So what will happen? That this will be drained out, water will be drained out. So for the short term condition, C will be cohesion will be effective cohesion, and phi will be effective phi. Are you getting my point? For the long term condition, this is the undrained condition. And here from the long term, this will be the phi dash and this will be the C dash and phi. Are you getting my point? So this is two basic difference. Again, I'm writing because see, for the short term, it means this is the undrained condition. Drainage has not occurred. For the long term, it means water is drained out. So here it will get effective condition, right? Okay, now we can go for calculation. See, so I'm calculating cache one, that is short term condition. It means undrained condition, and Cu will be here 80 and phi U will be 0. So now we can calculate. So for calculating the Qa NH, we have to calculate the Qu. Okay. So let's calculate the Qu. First, write the general expression CNC plus gamma DF NQ plus 0.5 gamma B N gamma. Right? Here the water level is at the foundation level. At the foundation level, it means this will be in the submerged condition, this will be in the bulk condition, or maybe saturated in the question saying. So whatever. Okay. So let's C we have 80, NC we have. So once phi is equal to 0 in this case, it means NC is given 5.7. But in the table, you can see it is mentioned 6. So we have to take this value. NC is equal to 6, NQ is equal to 1, and N gamma is equal to 2. So by putting the N gamma is equal to 0, this expression will be 0, right? When in the question it is not mentioning NC is not mentioned, then write 5.7. Once it is mentioned, then you have to take that value. So 6 plus, what is gamma? So unit weight above the water table is given 16. You can see. So 16 into depth of foundation. What is depth of foundation? 1 meter. Into NQ1. So we can calculate this value that we get 496 kilonewton per meter. So now we can calculate QNU, that is QU minus gamma DF. Directly you can also write NQ minus 1 for to calculate QNU, right? So you will get this value 496 minus 16 into 1. Will get 480 kilonewton per meter square. Right. So now we can calculate QNS, that is QNU, divided by factor of safety that is given in the question. That is 2. You can see here, factor of safety is given. So 480 divided by 2, you will get 240. Right. So we have calculated QNH for the short term condition. Now we can calculate for the case 2, long term condition. Long term condition, it means this is the condition for the drained. Means C dash, and that is 0, and phi dash, that is 30 degree. And for the phi dash 30 degree, this data is given. Bearing capacity factor are given, NC, NQ, N gamma. So first write the general expression, QCNC gamma DF NQ q plus 0.5 to the power. This is the strict footing, gamma b and gamma. So this will be also in the Sommers condition, right? And this will be in the bulk condition or whatever it is given. Unit weight of water above the water table is given 60. By putting the value c dash is equal to 0, this expression will be 0. So I'm writing 16 into df1 into nq, that is given 22.5 plus 0.5 into gamma. This is in the Sommers condition, right? Because the water table at the foundation level. So gamma saturated, we can be given 20. In the question, it is not mentioned what we have to take the unit weight of water. So we will take 9.81 into width. Width is given 2 meter and gamma is mentioned in the table, 19.7. So by calculation, you can get, I have calculated already. So I'm writing directly, I'm writing over here. So 560.743. Now we can calculate QNU, QU minus gamma DF, 560.743 minus gamma DF. So what will be gamma DF? 16. Into 1. So what you will get? Now we can calculate QNH. That is QNU divided by factor of safety. 544 divided by 0.43 divided by, what is factor of safety? 2. So we get 272.37. I have discussed so many questions like that. In this question, what is a new thing? This is new term, long term and short term condition. So that this question is very, very important, I would say. Okay, so we've calculated. Now let's go to calculate second. Also indicate the change that may occur in the short term value when the water level rises to the ground level. So now in this case, you can see we have calculated for the short term, when the water level at the foundation level, right? So we have that value. Suppose, let's give the name, that is QU1. And what we have calculated for short term, QNH, Q, this is the QNH we have calculated for this case. Let's give a name, 240. So that we have calculated already. So now we can calculate for this case, right? So let's calculate QU. At the general expression, short term condition means undrained. Phi U is given 80. CU given 80. Phi U is given 0. So when it is 0, can take the value of NC, NQ, N gamma. So in putting the value of N gamma is equal to 0, this expression will be 0. And this will be 1. So we can write C, 80 into 6 plus gamma. So you can see this is the condition where this will be in the Sommers condition, because this water table rises up to ground level, right? So we can write gamma saturated, that is, directly I'm writing 20 minus 9.81 into depth of foundation 1 to NQ 1. So we'll get this value. So I've calculated, I'm writing 490.19 kilonewton per meter square. So now we can calculate QNU divided, that is QU minus overburden pressure gamma DF you will get this 20 minus 9.81 into 1. So directly we can write nq minus 1, it will be 0. So we'll get this value 480 kilonewton. Okay, once we have nq and u, then we can calculate qnh by using the factor of safety. 480, what is factor of safety? 2. So you can see you got qnh for the second condition 240. In the first condition also it is 440, means there is no change. So now you can comment for the second case, you can comment there is no change in the net say bearing capacity of soil when the water table is rises to the ground level, right? See, in this question again, I'm repeating this short term, long term. Short term is there is no time for the drainage, means this is the condition for the undrainage. And long term is there is a time to drain out. So this condition is drain condition C, 5 days, here Cu and 5. So thank you. In the next lecture also I will discuss bearing capacity of soil. And then in the further lecture I will discuss shear strength of soil. So if you are really working hard for to get crack the GATE examination and to get the good rank in the GATE examination, so this lecture for you. Thank you.